Hi again. Okay, so I just grabbed a couple of my hats that I've made recently, just to show you. Okay, so here's one of them. Actually, the color's pretty accurate. kind of a rusty rainbow color, very long, very stretchy, so that you have different ways you can use it. But, basically, stick my hair in it, I can slouch it however I want to slouch it. It's kind of cool. I can cover up the back because it's really stretchy. I could even have the back hanging low and do like a funny ball thing at the end if I wanted to, probably. I don't know if you can see that. And I could like wrap it. It's cold. My daughter has one of these too. It's green. It's super cute. It's like a forest green color, and it's so big on her. She wears it as a hat and a scarf, and it disappears into it. If it's cold. See? Ah. Except I'd probably scrunch some more of it up on top because it's a little thin on top now. If I was gonna wear it on top. Yeah, and I can make these for not very expensive in a lot of different colors, so if you want one made, you should message me. They're not very expensive for me to make either, and it doesn't take me very long to make them. And there's different colors. I have like a pink color that's different tones of pinks, and I have another color that's like a rainbow, and I can probably custom dye one too, if you'd like me to. And they're probably good for normal hair too, you know? But when you're in the beginning stages of your dreads, one thing that I found that I liked a lot was hats. Because of those days that they're just like, you know, you walk around, sorry, looking outside. You walk around for a while with neglect dreads, but just looking kind of like you don't care. And it's fine, because, you know, it's part of the journey. But for days that you want to, like, look more professional or hide your locks a little bit more, sometimes fun hats are kind of cool to have. Anyway, they're really neat. You can use them as scarves. You can use it without putting your head through the tube as just a normal, like, scarf. What I've done with one of them that I don't have beside me, but I've actually taken one and made it into leggings, high leggings, to come down, like thigh highs, with a little bit of elastic. Super awesome. So if you're interested in any of that, message me. I can make you one for, like, you know, probably like $30, and get it sent out to you fairly quickly, because I'm not as busy right now, if you do that soon, or whenever, you know. I always have something going on, but I'm always making stuff, so most of my stuff gets out pretty fast, even if I have a list, because I'm literally constantly making stuff. These are some earmuffs that I made. That's like the top of them, and then the sides of them are little flowers. In the center of the flower, they're actually not quite done, but there's a little green in the center of each flower. And I want to actually put a little bead in each center. And then I'm going to actually be making, with that same color green, I'm going to be making some little leaves that come out, too. And then this is the main earmuff part, which is a flower with a heart in the middle and a little pink ball thing in the middle. And that's what they look like from the side. And the other side looks exactly the same. And then when they're on, I've been thinking about putting, like, these were supposed to dangle down originally, but then I found out that I have to have two strings to tie them on to be secure. They do have wire in them so that they stay on better than just cloth, and you can shape them. But to keep them on steady, I always tie them in the back, too. And then when I tie them in the back, those little two pieces that I like hanging down kind of disappear. So I'm thinking about making two pieces that look exactly like this come off the side. So they're down here almost like little earrings. But yeah, this is what that looks like. And they'll have little leaves coming off the side. Now I can make you a pair of earmuffs too, but they take a lot more time to make and they're a lot more detailed. So I'd probably sell a pair of earmuffs like this for maybe $60. I know that seems like a lot for earmuffs, but the amount of time it took me to make these is a crazy amount of time. We're talking like probably over 40 hours of work in all the detail. This is a different, it's a layered flower with different layers in it, you know, and then I had to make the muff part so they're actually warm, and I had to use special wire to match the yarn so you can't see it. And then they're really good quality. You could beat them up pretty good. You know, they fold up like earmuffs do for storage. Anyways, you know, if you wanted something more simple, I could probably do it for cheaper. It's hard when I do really unique pieces. They take a long time, and you're buying, like, a piece of artwork, too, you know? And right now, I'm actually kind of, that's my job, is my artwork. So I kind of need to get something for it. This is something I just finished the other day. And it's just a little half hat. And I actually didn't really like how this came out as much as I wanted it to. I guess it's okay, but the pink yarn that I used kept breaking because it was really thin in a few places. So I had to, like, right here, I had to tie it together so that, I don't know if you can see that, so that it wouldn't come apart. Instead of having it, there's another big obvious spot, so it wouldn't come undone. So I'm actually thinking about selling this piece that I have right here for, like, maybe $15. Normally I'd probably sell it for, like, $25, but because of the mistake in it. But you could just put it over, my hair's clean, I promise, if you buy this piece. But, you know, it's kind of like, and the colors in it, you can stretch it and do different things with it. The colors in it are definitely something you could wear if you're a man or if you're a woman. Because they're like some rust colors mixed with, there's a, you know, a couple lines of a burgundy and a light pink, but it's just this much. And then there's a green and a light blue. And this is actually not crocheted, this is knit. But, yeah. I don't know, maybe we could trade somebody for it, too. But that's another thing I have. And then this hat I made, like, 2 years ago. And I love this thing. I'm going to put it on. I just changed the wire in it. I didn't have to change the wire out for 2 years, which is awesome. So if you get something from me in the wire, and I didn't have to change it, and the wire I used in this hat originally was pipe cleaner, so it was crappy, and I put new wire in it that's strong. I might actually put pipe cleaner back in it for a softer ruffle, but anyway, it's harder to put my hair in it now, though, because I have way more hair than I used to, but it's my flower hat, and it looks like a blossom, or like some people have called it a hat and a cat kind of hat, or an Alice in Wonderland kind of hat, and it's, I call it my flower hat because I intended it being like kind of a bud and like a blossom on top look up here. You can tuck your hair in. You can also drawstring this closed if you don't have as much hair as me. Well, I mean, I'm not going to sell this hat because I love it and I've used it a lot. But you can like totally mold the part around your face in any shape you want. So you can go like this with a strap underneath, or you can like point it and make it into a dinosaur hat is what I like to call it. Like, I don't know if I can do this on the camera. It's really hard, it's all backwards. You kind of have like two little ear things coming out and like a point. Or before, when I had the pipe cleaner in, I could make a softer ruffle so it just looked like a flower ruffle. This is a tougher wire. So it's kind of hard to get it to ruffle the way I liked to ruffle it when it had pipe cleaner in it. I can still kind of get that going. All sorts of things. If you don't like the ruffle, I mean, you can like do something like that. Anyway, I could probably make another hat that looks like this too, but this is also a very unique piece. And I haven't really made any to sell, so I'd probably sell these hats for, like, I don't know, quite a bit too, like maybe 70, like 60 or 70. But anyway, I love this thing. I've had it, like I said, I've worn it like every winter whenever it's cold. It's really warm, and I've worn it quite a lot. It's been through the washing machine a lot, and it's still in really good shape. I use it all the time when it rains, and it rains here a lot. You can just hang dry it when it rains. If you wash it, I wouldn't recommend drying it fully. I would only recommend drying it for like maybe 10 minutes or so, or on fluff, and then hang drying it, because the wool I used is, or the acrylic stuff, well, it's a mix of acrylic and wool, but the wool will shrink if you dry it all the way, and you need to wash it on a cold setting. But I have like 3 or 4 different kinds of yarn that I've used in the hat, and a lot of my yarns that I use in my pieces are actually raw wool that I get from this alpaca farm that I twist myself, and then I dye it. I do dye batches in my kitchen and dye different wool. So a lot of my crocheted stuff is also uniquely colored. Anyways, I just want to show you those things, and I have other things that I could show you that I crocheted that are kind of cool, leg warmers and sweaters and coats and stuff like that, but this is a top. I have a purple one too. It's got shells that are dangle, but yeah, something like this wouldn't cost that much. It doesn't take too long for me to make, but you know, depending on how long it takes and what the material cost is. I trade too though. Anyway, bye.